Good morning. I'm here with my colleague, the member for Mayo, Rebecca Sharkey, who is the education spokesperson for the NXT. We'll be talking about education in just a moment, but firstly in relation to the unfolding a terrible tragedy in London, the Grenfell Tower tragedy, where at least 58 people have died. I note that the opposition is calling for further reviews of this. Of course, that is something that I support, and in fact, there is an inquiry that I instigated several years ago that will be looking at this issue, and it's something that I'll be putting on the agenda of the Senate Economics Committee. This is an issue that requires absolute bipartisan, non-partisan support, in the sense that it needs to be looked at by all sides with a particular focus on safety. We need to have a national audit of buildings around the country because it seems to me that that is something that was not done after the La Crosse fire in Melbourne in 2014, at the end of 2014. The London tragedy is more than just a wake-up call. There are now no excuses for any government at a local, state or federal level not to do everything possible to ensure the safety of the occupants and visitors to those buildings. On the issue of education, of course, we put a number of proposals to the government yesterday. I've been working this weekend with Rebecca on this issue. We want there to be a good outcome for the students of Australia, and I'll hand over to Rebecca to give you an idea of some of the issues that we've been raising with the government.
Parliament this week has the potential to put through some really good legislation that will support students, that will support children starting school next year. Now, we've recognised from the very beginning that there's a number of weaknesses in this legislation, but we think, positively, that there'll be a good outcome at the end. We think that this is the potential to create a truer version of Gonski. We're mindful that it's supported by so many people who are part of the original Gonski. So David Gonski, Ken Boston, Catherine Greiner, and more broadly, there's wider support, including Adrian Pilley. So we think it's going to be an interesting week, and we're very keen to continue discussions with government. And let's hope and keep our fingers crossed that we can do what the Parliament should be doing, and that's all working together for the best for our children.
Have you taken questions?
Could you just clarify quickly what those weaknesses you've identified are and what you're seeking from the government at this point?
Certainly. We think the 10-year timeframe is too long. We think that a child that's starting school next year, a five-year-old, shouldn't need to wait until they're 15 until the true Gonski reform package is in place. We're also concerned that state governments and territory governments don't need to do their share of lifting and increase their contribution. We've seen in the past, whenever the feds have tipped in more, states have a habit of reclining their commitments. There's a number of other measures that we're concerned about. We hear the Catholic sector is concerned that the SES calculations, so that's postcodes that determine the capacity of parents, perhaps that could be reviewed as well.
I know the Greens are looking for a six-year funding time frame instead of the 10. You mentioned you want a shorter time frame. Is that sort of where you're landing?
Look, most certainly. I mean, we don't like anything outside of the forward estimates, but certainly 6 years is much better than 10 years.
So what do you think of those concessions offered by the government to the Greens? Do they align with your proposals?
Look, they certainly do. I haven't heard the Greens talk about whether SES calculations should be perhaps reviewed again by David Gonski. Look, I think we've got some good bones here, and I think by the end of the week, we'd like to see that this legislation can get through, but with a number of important improvements.
I mean, look, let's not let toxic politics get in the way of good policy that will benefit our students. When you hear people such as Ken Boston, who was part of the original Gonski panel, saying if we don't do this, have a package going through, obviously with improvements, that it will be a loss of a historic opportunity to improve outcomes for students across the country, then I think that we've seen what happens in this country when toxic politics get in the way, whether it's in energy policy and now in education policy. Here's an opportunity to do something actually very good for students across the country.
We heard reports over the weekend that Catholic schools would actually lose out in the Gonski 2.0. How much of a concern is that for your party?
Well, I think we've addressed, but do you want to...
Even this morning on radio, the Catholic sector have said that they're unsure of how much they think that they would be losing. Certainly the calculations we've received from government, you would and show that they're not losing money, but they're receiving a slower rate of growth, simply because they're closer to that 80% contribution from the federal government. Now,
20% state.
Yeah, 80% So, we've been working on this all weekend. It's been a long weekend,
yeah,
hasn't
right.
it?
2 day weekend was a long weekend.
I think I can understand every sector wants more. What we want to create, though, is a sector-blind, needs-based funding. This is about the students in every single school and their parents' capacity. And I think what we're seeing is quite a fair proposal by government. And it is it's more closely aligned to the original Gonski idea than the previous Labor government.
Senator Xenophon, you've been around the Senate a long time. You reckon the government can get this one through this week?
I've been around the Senate long enough to know that anything can happen, and I think, as Rebecca said, said in the last 48 hours to the media, schools want certainty, parents want certainty, students deserve certainty, and I think we should at least give this our absolute best in terms of negotiating with the government with goodwill and good faith, as should the government, try and get this through. We're not quite there yet, but I think that this has many elements of a good package. It needs improvement, but I don't want the perfect to be the enemy of the good. I think we can actually do some good things this week. So the short answer is, who knows? Thank you.
Thanks.